Going into this, I know what most of you are probably thinking. You're thinking, yes, the MCU should reboot the X-Men, obviously. And up until recently, I probably would have agreed with you, but lately I've gotten to thinking, and I've wondered if rebooting the X-Men is actually the MCU's best course of action. I don't think it's as clear-cut as a yes or no answer. That probably confused you. What do you mean it's not a yes or no answer? Of course it is. Well, trust me, I don't think it is. And in this video, I'm going to explain to you why I don't think it's a clear-cut answer. And it really begs the question, should an MCU reboot of the X-Men be done? Now, before I get too far into the video, I want to emphasize what I mean by a reboot. The MCU is obviously going to have the X-Men in the MCU. The question isn't should they do that, the question is should they reboot the Fox characters, or should they port the Fox characters into the MCU via the multiverse? Now, you might have strong opinions one way or another, so here's mine. Now, first of all, I do need to address the Fox-sized elephant in the room. The X-Men films. The Fox X-Men films seem to be the most unbalanced and all over the place superhero continuity. The first two were solid. The third one was a massive disappointment. Then they walked themselves off a cliff with X-Men Origins Wolverine before recovering 2 years later with X-Men First Class. And then they gave us The Wolverine, which I think was a pretty solid movie, and then they topped that with one of the greatest superhero films of all time in X-Men Days of Future Past. A couple years later, we got Deadpool, and they did it again. They gave us a good one, but then, a couple months later, they walked themselves off another cliff with X-Men Apocalypse, and the next year, they gave us what I consider to be the greatest film Marvel has ever made, which is Logan. A year after that, we get Deadpool 2, which is good, but not great. But then 1 year later, they walked themselves off another cliff with X-Men Dark Phoenix, a film so bad, I still haven't seen it. And then The New Mutants got delayed a crap ton, went through a studio purchase, and released a movie I think is pretty entertaining, but I gotta admit, it really did send the Fox X-Men continuity out with a whimper, and not a bang. It's jarring to see a franchise go from great to terrible to even better to even more terrible so quickly. And the X-Men franchise is probably the most notorious franchise when it comes to doing this. So despite a lot of that all being so shit, why would I say no to a reboot? Because there is also a lot of really good that came out of this franchise, and I would love to see more of that explored at a company that consistently produces good content. Let's talk about the biggest reason why I think a hard reboot may not be necessary. Warning from here on out. There are a lot of rumored characters in Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, one of which I'm going to be discussing in depth in this video. So even though it's rumored, if you want to know absolutely nothing about Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, click off this video now, because I will be spoiling a possible character's return in that movie. You have been warned. Rumor around the block is that Sir Patrick Stewart is going to appear in Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness as Charles Xavier. And you know what? I am actually positive that he's going to be in this movie. I released a video ranking the likelihood of characters being in Multiverse of Madness, and I gave Patrick Stewart a 9 out of 10. I am confident that he's going to be in the movie. So here's the issue. Patrick Stewart as Professor X is among the greatest comic book casting decisions of all time. And once he's put into an MCU movie, even if it's just for a few minutes, he's going to kill the role. And then people will just be disappointed when Patrick Stewart isn't the mainline Xavier going forward. Something like this works for Spider-Man No Way Home, for example, because by the time Tobey and Andrew made their returns to the screen, the MCU had already had its own Peter Parker that we had grown to care about. But if you put Patrick Stewart as Xavier in an MCU movie before casting an MCU version of Xavier, the only Xavier memory people will have is the time that he came into the MCU, crushed the role, and left. And the next actor for Charles Xavier will forever be living in Patrick Stewart's shadow. And that Patrick Stewart shadow will loom over the entire MCU X-Men. It also doesn't help that Ryan Reynolds is getting a third Deadpool movie and characters like Michael Fassbender's Magneto, James McAvoy's Patrick Stewart, Sophie Turner's Jean Grey, or even the goddamn Wolverine played by Hugh Jackman are rumored to pop up in this movie. And if we see all or even one of these characters in Multiverse of Madness, it just means that the MCU is prioritizing a completely different X-Men universe over their own. Now, trust me, I do not want every aspect of the X-Men to come from a different universe. I do think having a mutant X gene in the MCU is a good idea, and just having certain members of the X-Men come in through the MCU that don't have MCU counterparts. For example, Willem Dafoe's Green Goblin. There is not a Green Goblin in the MCU. There's not Norman Osborn. They explicitly say that. But Willem Dafoe's Green Goblin serves as the MCU's Green Goblin. Now, 10 years ago, I would have said it's likely to have everyone come in through the multiverse, but we need to be honest with ourselves. Patrick Stewart is not going to be able to do this forever. I think the main reason I want some of these characters to come from the Fox continuity is that there is massive storytelling potential with some of these. Fox made great decisions with some of these characters, and some of the ones that they really screwed up were given younger counterparts later on that were supposed to carry the franchise, but then Disney bought Fox. I was always a big fan of Sophie Turner's casting as Jean Grey. I know some people weren't, but my issue was the writing, because the two movies she appeared in are booty cheeks. Ty Sheridan is an actor who I have really started to like more and more the more stuff I see him in. Saw him in a couple movies this year. The dude's a good actor. I think he deserves another shot at Cyclops. Also, Fox blueballed us with the greatest superhero suit ever put on screen, and then they ditched it in the next movie. Still pissed off about that. My favorite Fox casting choice, though, besides Hugh Jackman and Patrick Stewart, is Michael Fassbender as Magneto. And honestly, that casting decision almost became this entire video. The whole video almost became about Michael Fassbender's Magneto and not wanting him to be rebooted. But then I branched it out into talking about all the X-Men in general. And that, ladies and gentlemen, brings me to the Scarlet Witch. Wanda Maximoff has gone from a character who is sidelined to a front runner to a fan favorite in just a few years, and the Wanda Maximoff hype train does not seem to be ending anytime soon. Unless, of course, she dies in Multiverse of Madness, but I don't think she's going to. In the comics, Wanda Maximoff is the daughter of Magneto. Now, the MCU, I don't think it's going that route, unless they retcon it that her Sokovian parents were her adopted parents, but I highly doubt it. I just don't think Magneto is her dad in the MCU. So try to remember X-Men Apocalypse for a second. Now, I know that's a hard ask, but just try. The best scene in that film was the scene after Magneto's family died. And I say that's the best scene because Michael Fassbender just does some incredible acting in that scene.
My name isn't Henrik. My name is Magneto.
Now picture this, right? Michael Fassbender's Magneto and Elizabeth Olsen's Wanda Maximoff end up in some sort of team up or some sort of fight, but either way, they end up sharing the screen together. Wanda has no father. Magneto has no daughter. both were taken from them at one of the happiest points in their lives. Now, Wanda starts to see Magneto as a father figure, and Magneto might start to see Wanda as a daughter figure, and he wants her to be powerful, and he wants her to live up to her true potential, and he wants to protect her. And right there, ladies and gentlemen, you have a great Magneto and Scarlet Witch storyline. They don't have to be biological family, but they can still be family in some way. And that storyline is not possible without the multiverse. But boys, it does not end there. So let's talk about the mother Wolverine. We need to be real with ourselves and realize that no one else will ever be able to play Wolverine. Now that's obviously not true. Someone else can play Wolverine and they could be able to do it very well. But Hugh Jackman was so good in the role that so many people will never see anyone ever playing Wolverine. So what if they just don't have someone else play Wolverine? Daphne Keene as X-23 was great casting, and I think it would be wasted potential to not utilize the popularity of that character in the MCU and make some money off the success of Logan. It would seem pointless to recast Wolverine and start fresh after the way Logan ended. So we don't need another Wolverine. What we need is X-23. Bring Laura in through the multiverse. Have her find the X-Men. Have her join the X-Men. Whether it's a young group of mutants or the mainline X-Men, doesn't matter. But have her join Xavier's school and interact with all those people. And most importantly, have her mention Wolverine and how he died for her and how he protected her, and just talk about Hugh Jackman's Wolverine. The real Wolverine. Not a new Wolverine. The Hugh Jackman Wolverine. Directly reference the events of Logan. And if you do that, it's like Hugh Jackman's Wolverine is in the MCU. Despite him never coming into the MCU, despite him always staying dead in the Fox universe, if you have X-23 come in and mention him, it is almost like he plays an important part in the MCU. And right there, Hugh Jackman's Wolverine is canonized without ever being the MCU's Wolverine. And then on top of that, they get to use X-23 and just directly follow up her story after the ending of Logan. The beauty of the multiverse is that characters can come from any time, right? Green Goblin came from 2002, Doc Ock came from 2004, Electro came from 2013, I think, is when Amazing Spider-Man 2 takes place, even though that's not when it came out. And then Toby and Andrew came from 2021. They can come from anywhere. That means you can mix and match some of these characters, and it'll be a bit jarring at first, but audiences will just come to terms with it. Michael Fassbender's Magneto, who was active in the 60s, could interact with Daphne Keene's X-23, who was active in the late 2020s. We could see Sophie Turner Jean Grey interact with Patrick Stewart's Charles Xavier, or Ty Sheridan's Cyclops could fight alongside Halle Berry's Storm, because in the multiverse, anything is possible. And that also means they can ignore the shitty stuff and keep all the good stuff. Dark Phoenix sucked. Good. Don't mention it. Jean Grey was sucked into the MCU before the events of that movie even happened. So to her, none of that went down. So then to the audience, we don't even need to acknowledge the existence of Dark Phoenix. X-Men Origins Wolverine was a pile of shit. Good. The MCU can acknowledge that movie less than the Fox movies already did. And Deadpool? Well, Deadpool can break the fourth wall so we can have all sorts of fun. We don't even need any creative reason why Deadpool's in the MCU. Just have Deadpool 3 be in the MCU, and he keeps acknowledging that he's in a different universe now because of a studio buyout, and have him poke a bunch of fun at that. Honestly, kind of expecting them to do that, and it'd be a missed opportunity if they didn't. And you can't tell me that you don't want Anya Taylor-Joy to return as Magic. Because you're lying if you tell me that you want her to be recast. There is so much beauty in all of these characters that they don't even need to work too hard to figure out what to do with these characters. Just pull some of them in from a different universe, drop them into the MCU, and call it a day. Then just write good movies for them. Because last time they did that, it made over $1 billion in the middle of a pandemic, and as of yesterday, I believe, became the 6th highest grossing film of all time. Do I need to reiterate that we're in the middle of a pandemic? So just do that again. Will it make sense? Make it make sense. Who cares? It's the multiverse. Anything is possible. As long as the stories for these characters are good, I don't care if they're from the multiverse or not. I will watch it and I will love it. The Fox films had some beautiful casting and some incredible storylines, and even though not all of it was great, I'm not quite ready to say goodbye to that continuity just yet, especially because some of the actors, i.e. Hugh Jackman and Patrick Stewart, had been doing it for 17 years, and it's not easy to just get rid of them and bring in a new group of actors just like that. But if they do, they need to do a mix. Don't use the multiverse to bring in every mutant. Have mutants in the MCU, and just bring in some from the multiverse that you then decide don't need to have MCU counterparts. It worked for Green Goblin. It can work for Xavier, or Magneto, or Jean Grey, or X-23. Characters that never got their due, or never really got a great adaptation, or never even got a chance in the spotlight, could totally originate from the MCU. Characters like Mystique, or Gambit, or even Beast to a degree, could just be some MCU mutants that we see join this team once the multiverse cracks and they all kind of come together. We could get a mishmash of different mutants from all these different universes, and as long as they write it well, it will be fine. And I know it'll be fine because a few weeks ago, I watched Willem Dafoe's Green Goblin beat the shit out of Tom Holland's Spider-Man, and it worked. I would find. So it can work again. Right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. What are your thoughts on the X-Men in the MCU? Do they think... Alright, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. What are your thoughts on an X-Men MCU reboot? Do they... Alright, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. What are your thoughts on an MCU X-Men reboot? Do you think they should reboot the whole thing? Do you think they should bring some people in through the multiverse? Do you think they should bring everyone in through the multiverse? Let me know down in the comments below. I would love to know. Also, real fast, I do have an Instagram I'm trying to be more active on this year. I'll drop the link to it in the description below. Definitely go check that out. Sometimes I'll announce videos or post updates for certain videos on my Instagram. So if you want to be in the loop before a lot of people, go check out my Instagram. It's a fun time. Also, be sure to leave a like on this video, subscribe, click on the bell icon to receive all notifications from the MCU HQ. You can check out a couple other videos right here, and that's going to be it. Have a great day, guys.